I am quite obsessed with no-code design platforms. The thing is, I feel quite comfortable coding, but I know that my development skills will never meet all my design ideas. So every time I come across a new no-code platform, I kind of need to try it and see how it feels. Today, I'm going to try Wix's latest platform, Wix Studio. I want to say thank you to Wix for sponsoring this video and for giving me early access to the platform so I can show you how it works. If you've seen my latest video on Wix Studio, you'll see that there's a huge difference between Wix Studio and other platforms. The main difference is that Wix Studio is not built for you to create a portfolio and publish it. Wix Studio has been created for agencies and freelancers who have to manage multiple clients and multiple projects. So today, instead of creating a website and publishing it, I'm going to build a template for a landing page that I might be able to reuse for multiple clients. The page itself will be quite simple because I don't want to spend too much time on the design, but I'm going to walk you through some of Wix Studio's most exciting features. So let's go. So the first thing we are going to do is have a look at the design. I've built it in Figma just to have a sort of template or an idea of how I want the layout. But in reality, when I work with it and when I reconvert it into a Wix Studio website, some things might change. Now, the design itself is incredibly simple because the point of this video is not to have a look at how to design a landing page. So I've come up with literally the simplest design ever. So the website is super simple. At the top, it has a navigation that we might or might not add into Wix Studio because this is just like a one page landing page, so we might not need it, but I've added just to have it as a reference. At the top of everything, we have a hero section, we have some text on one side, we have some sort of visuals or images on the other side. Then we have a couple of sections. At the top, we have our work, and then below we have our services. And then we have like a CTA, get in touch, our email, and then at the bottom, a footer, which again, we might or might not use. So the next thing to do is to go on Wix Studio and create a blank canvas to create the design. So we are going to go to Wix Studio, hit create new site, and start from a blank canvas. So this is our blank canvas. By default, it comes with a navigation and it comes with a footer. And for now, we are going to leave it like that just because I don't want to waste too much time. So let's create the first bit, which is the header section. And if we go back to our design, we can see that the way it's designed already, it tells us how we can organize it. So on one side we have the text and on the other side we have the images. So we can split this section in two, and we have a quick way to do it, which is literally select this sort of layout and it creates two columns for us. That's it, that's perfect. In order for it to not go onto the margins of the side, I'm going to add a bit of padding. And I'm gonna say 3%, and I'm gonna make sure it's connected so all sides are exactly the same. Then we can go ahead and add our bits of text. So here at the top, I'm gonna say text, and I'm just going to add like a heading in here. And I think it's a bit too large, so I'm gonna change it to heading 2. Yep, and I'm just going to copy my bit of text. Cool. So I have my three pieces of text, and I want to make sure that the distance between each one of them is correct, that they occupy the space that they need to occupy. So for me, the best way to lay them out is to select all three of them and select stack. This way it creates literally a stack of the three pieces of text. And if I go here, I can control how much spacing is between each one of them. So maybe I can say 5%. That's nice. And then I'm going to select the whole thing and center it in its container. There we go. So we have our bit of text on one side. Now let's add the image on the other side. I'm going to say add media, and you can select any image here. I'm going to use an image that I have in mind, and we can add it to the page. So you can see by default, it's stretched to occupy as much as possible, even if at this point it's going beyond the edges of the container. So we can quickly go here so it's unstretched and it takes its original size. So there we go. We have our header already in place. So let's go and add a couple of sections. One thing you could do in order to save time, and especially if you don't have like a clear design in mind, is to use the already built section. Now, I know that at this point we already have a design, but we can have a look and see if there are any sections that kind of fit our layout or the idea that we want for our design. So you quickly go to Add Elements, and below Sections, you have all these already designed sections that, I mean, to be honest, if you don't want to spend time designing on Figma first, you can just go ahead and drag and drop any sections that you like. So for this one, I'm gonna go below About and select this one. It's not exactly the same, but it has this idea of some text at the top and some images below, so we can try it out and see if it works. I'm gonna drag it below our header section. There we go. It's already added. What I'm going to do though is keep the consistency of having all our background in white, just because it's easier then to make sure everything looks exactly the same. And then if we want to add some background, if we want to add some more details to it, we can do it really quickly. So it's not exactly the same, but we can work with it. In our original section, we have these fonts here, we have this bit of text, and we don't really have a button. So we can go ahead and delete the button. So what we can do actually is, in our original design, we have the large text at the bottom and the small text above. In here, it's the other way around. So because this is a stack, we can change the order in which the elements appear. So if we go to our layers and go to stack, we can change the order and make the large text go below the small text. And now it's as simple as copying this one. There we go. And I can write this down. And now it's as easy as changing these images as we've done above. So I'll quickly do that. I think this looks pretty much like our design, so yeah. The next section that we have is a bit different because we're going to use a repeater. So let's have a look at the design here. So again, we have some bit of text at the top, we have like the main title, and then we have three elements that look quite similar, even if the one in the middle is slightly different. But they all have an icon at the top, some text, like a title, a bit of a paragraph, and a button. And you might think, well, I just need to design one, copy and paste, and then if I need to make some changes, I can go ahead and make it on each one. But Wix Studio has a really cool way to do this, which is a repeater. And to do that, I'm gonna go and duplicate this section very quickly, just because I want to save time. And I'm going to remove the fonts here because I don't need them for this. Cool. And what I'm going to add on this cell is a repeater. So you go on the quick adds, you select layout tools, and on repeaters, you select this one and just drop it here. So the way this works is like components on Figma or symbols on other tools. You design one of the elements that works as a master, and any change that you apply to that master component, it applies to the other ones. That's why it's called a repeater. So first thing I'm going to do is give it a bit more space. So let's go at the options that repeaters offer. So you can select the display type that you want. We could have them as a list, we could have them as a slider, but we want them as cards. We want them to go left to right. We want them to have space in between because I'm going to stretch this. And I'm going to say there are three items per row. This way I have the items that I want and just three of them. I want them to have some space in between. Yeah, something like that will do it. Let's design this element and just this element to here. We only need to design it once and that will work. I'm going to add some text to here and you'll see what happens. Yeah, a heading is added to each one of the components. So just gonna make sure it's centered. Cool. And I'm gonna say here, the good thing here is because we don't want all of them to say exactly the same, is that you can go ahead and change the text into all of this. I'm gonna quickly add the other elements of this card and then show you how you can customize it. Cool. So we have our three cards. And one thing that's really cool is that you can see in our design, the one in the middle is different. So you might think, okay, if I have a component that I've designed a certain way, how do I have one, just one, that will look different? And the way we can do this is by setting up an IB design pattern. So under layout on the inspector with your repeater selected, we can go ahead and turn this on. And what this does is select this as an item B. And what we can do now is change the appearance of this one and just this one and don't have the other ones involved, let's say. So we can change this and I'm gonna change the color of the button and that's it. You can see how easy it is to change just the properties of one element. The last thing we need to do is to add the main CTA at the bottom, which should be fairly simple because it's just a bit of text and a link. So let's do that really quickly. I'm going to slightly change the original design that we had, and because everything seems fairly central, I'm just going to keep it as a bit of text in the center, just because I think it looks better aesthetically. So in order to save my time, I'm going to select this section and I'm going to say duplicate, just because all of this is a matter of creating a template fairly quickly so that you can reuse it and tweak it as much as you can for other projects. So let's do this. I'm going to remove this repeater here because we don't need it for this. Cool, there we go. So obviously this is a very simple one page landing page that you can reuse for your needs for multiple companies and agencies, and you can just do with it whatever you want. I'm gonna quickly, very quickly add some animations, some transitions, just to make it feel a bit more polished. But that would be basically it. You can use repeaters, you can use the already designed section to make your life easier, or you can just drag and drop elements and position them and lay them out as you want. So let's have a quick go at some animations. Cool, so these are all our animations added. Let's have a look at how everything looks put together. There we go. We have some quick interactions here when you hover over. Same here. Yeah, that's it. Quick and simple. We don't want to overdo it at this point, but feel free to go crazy with any interactions and animations that you want. This is the point for you to experiment and see what's possible with Wix Studio. So you've seen how quickly it is to create a site with Wix Studio. Now the only thing left is to turn this site into a reusable custom template that we can use as many times as we want. And that is exactly what we'll do on the next video. So see you soon.